सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यन्तां वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतं वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। ॐ नमो ब्रह्मादिभ्यो ब्रह्मविद्यासम्प्रदायकर्तृभ्यो ऋषिभ्यो महद्भ्यो नमो गुरुभ्यः। सर्वोपप्लवरहितः प्रज्ञानघनः प्रत्यगर्तो ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि ब्रह्मैवाहमस्मि। नारायणं पद्मभुवं वसिष्ठं शक्तिञ्च तत्पुत्रपराशरञ्च व्यासं शुकं गौडपदं महान्तं गोविन्दयोगीन्द्रमथास्य शिष्यं श्रीशङ्कराचार्यमथास्य पद्मपादं च हस्तामलकं च शिष्यं तन्तोटकं वार्तिकारमन्यान् अस्मद्गुरून् सन्ततमानस्मि। So we were looking at the Shadi Punya Paripak or Shadi Dhani Swachit Yoga. I think we finished the fourth verse, right? So we looked at the fourth verse. Anyway, let's do the Mangalacharana of the Tika and the Vyakhya. यद् ब्रह्म गोचर विचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसार धीजनित दुःखम् अभूज्जनस्य यद् ब्रह्म धीजनित सौख्यम् अभूज्य तस्य तं रुक्मिणी सहित कृष्णमहं नमामि। यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदरापमहत्पदं तमामाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकजाङ्गमनन्त सुखाकृतिम्। Somebody wants to join in. Kindly mute yourself if you are unmuted. Okay. So we looked at the fifth verse as well. I think yodrishyate yam satya chidatma shishyadi punyapa anim. I think we looked at the sixth verse also in Ratna Prabha, Shri Gauriyam. We looked at the, okay, so that was the Tika. Okay, so we looked at the second verse in the Ratna Prabha. Then the third Mangalacharana Shloka is, Yat Kripalava Matrena Muko Bhavati Panditaha Veda Shastra Shariraantam Vanim Veenakaram Bhaje. So Saraswati is being praised and he says, I worship bhaje, aham bhaje, whom I worship, I pray to one who has veena in her kara. So veena kare yasyaha sa veena kara tam veena karam aham bhaje, also called as vani. So vanim veenakaram vanim tam veenakaram vanim aham bhaje. So who is that tam? Yat krupalava matrena. So yat and tat will go together. So yat krupalava matrena yasyaha krupalava matrena, just by a bit of krupa, bit of her compassion. Muko bhavati panditaha. So she is that kind of vani devi whose just a little compassion of hers, you know, in Saundarilehari or in Lalita Sahasrara, you will see, you know, just a mere glance of Devi, you can get, so you can get the Panditya. So here it is said, Mukha, even a, you know, a dumb person will become a Pandita, would become a Pandita. Veda Shastra Shariram, And why is it so? One is because she is in the form of, manifest in the form of Vani. So Kalidasa is said to have become a Pandita by the blessings of the Devi. He was a Moodha otherwise. And then he went on to become a famous scholar. She has a Sharira of Vedas itself. So Vedas are her Sharira, manifest in the form of Vedas. That is what is Veda Shastra Shariram. So Veda is a Shastra, and Veda Shastram, or Veda Shastrani also if you want to take in plural, Shariram Yasyaha Sa Veda Shastra Sharira Tam Veda Shastra Shariram Vani Vinakaram Vani Aham Bhaje कामाक्षिदत्त दुग्ध प्रचुरसुरनुत प्राज्य भोज्याभिपूज्य श्री गौरी नायका प्रकटन शिव रामा यलब्धात्म बोधैहि श्रीमद् गोपाल गीर्भिः प्रकटित परमाद्वैत भासास्मितास्य श्रीमद् गोविंद वाणी चरण कमल गो निरुतो हंयथालिः. सो बिफोर वी गो इनटू द फोर्थ वर्स श्री गौरी आम वी फिनिश दी second verse, but there is a tika which you had to look into. So let's see what we get there. So the Tikakara starts by, in fact he has commented on the first verse also, which we saw, apishabdasya vrutkamaina anvayaha. Then in the about the second verse before saying that, arisahodara, we saw that. So tatastha lakshana, there was a question yesterday, by the way. After the patha, there was a question. I had given an example of Tatastha Lakshana as a crow sitting on the house. So while pointing out the house, somebody asks, you know, where is this Devadatta's house? So he points out, the guy says that this is Devadatta's house. What you see, where the crow is sitting. So you have, let's say, row houses, and all houses look the same. Even if they don't look the same, how do you identify? By saying that, you know, there's a crow sitting there, that is the house. Now that crow is not incidental to it. But there is a question as to this is Upalakshana, not a Tatastha Lakshana. It is not an Upalakshana. What is an Upalakshana? Upalakshana is, if at all in that very Lakshana, if the crow isn't sitting and a pigeon or a some other bird is sitting there. A peacock is sitting, let's say. You're in a forest area and then the peacock is sitting there. But you won't get confused. Let's say, a crow is sitting there, and then the other person says that I don't see a crow, I see a pigeon. But then the pigeon is included in saying that there is a crow sitting. The Lakshana is about the house, not about the crow sitting there. So the crow is Upalakshana. Kaka is Upalakshana, the pigeon is included in Kaka. So if the pigeon is sitting there, you just made a statement and the other says that, oh, I don't see a crow, I see a pigeon there. So crow was Upalakshana for the pigeon also. That is an Upalakshana. By stating one, the others get included, the group gets included, that is Upalakshana. Tatastha Lakshana is Tate Tishtati Iti. It is not incidental. The crow is on the Tata of the Lakshana, of the house. So it is not a part of the house, that is Tatastha Lakshana. The example for Upalakshana is not this. The Kaka sitting on the Griha is not the example for the Upalakshana. Upalakshana example, Kakebhyo Dadi Rakshatam. So the mother tells the child, she puts out the curd and says, protect the curd from the crows. There the crow is Upalakshana. So the child cannot say that, oh, I let the cat come and eat up the curd because you only told me to protect it from crows. All birds, all animals, anything that can take away the curd from that animal or whatever, from that species, you have to protect the curd. That is Upalakshana, not Tatastha Lakshana. Here it is Tatastha Lakshana. The example is the house which is being pointed out using something which is not incidental to the definition. Lakshana is a definition. So Jagat Kartrutvam Isitrutvam. So तज्जलाना छांदोग्य तज्जलाना तस्मात् जातः दिस एंटायर प्रपंच हैज कम आउट फ्रॉम ब्रह्म देन तज्ज 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 तद्दल सो जलान सो तज्ज इज तज्जा मीन्स तस्मात् जातः एंड देन तस्मिन् लीयते तल्ल एंड अन अन इज प्राण प्र प्लस अन इफ यू सी देन यू गेट प्राण सो सस्टेनेंस इज इंक्लूडेड बाय सेइंग दैट द प्राण इज ऑल्सो ड्यू टू द सेम जगत कारण ब्रह्म नाउ दिस इज अ तटस्थ लक्षण सगुण ब्रह्मास प्रेज इज ऑल्सो ऑल इन द वर्सेस तटस्थ लक्षण It is not incidental to Brahma because of the mere fact of being a guna. Being a guna in nirguna Brahma where there cannot be a guna, cannot be swarupa lakshana, it is tatastha lakshana. So anyway, so back to the tika. So Purnanandiya says, Shri Gauriyaiti, what was said in the Moola, in the Ratna Prabha, in the Vyakhya as what? Shri Gaurya, this Anuswara is a mistake there. Shri Gaurya Sakalarthadam Nijapadam. Nijapadam Bhojena Mukti Pradam. But what has been said, Shri Gaurya Sakalarthadam and Shri Dundhi Tundasina Praudham Vignavanam Harantam. By himself, he just shows Vairagya and shows that there is no other Sukha superior to Vairagya. By having charma kapala ityadi only, these are his upakaranas, and he shows that vairagya saukhyat param nasti iti. Pradishantam, he teaches that. And what does he give you? He gives you nija padam bhojena mukti pradam. So he is mukti pradata, he gives you mukti by his own, you know, his lotus feet. Those who take refuge unto Shiva. However, he needs the others as karanas. Tritiya, so Karanarthi Tritiya. So Shri Gauri is a Karana, Upakarana, Karana which assists in getting things done for the devotees of Shiva if the devotee wants Sakalartha, any Artha and protects from all the Vignas using by the means of Shri Ganesha. So now that is being elaborated in the Tika as Shri Gaurya Ityadi Tritiyatrayam Karanarthakam. It is in the sense of Karana, Karane Tritiya, Karanam Nama Asadharanam Karanam. And what is a Karana? Asadharana Karana. There are many Karanas, Samanya Karanas, but this is a specific cause. For every Artha, the Kala has to be right. It is all in space. So space and time are common. Ishvara is also Samanya Karana for everything. You cannot have anything without Ishvara's Anugraha, who is a Karma Phaladata. So Samanya Karana Ishvara is, but specific cause is needed. Asamanya Karana, that is Asadharana. Sadharana Karana is Ishvara, Kala, Ityadi, but Asadharana Karana is called as Karana. Among the many Karanas, only the Asadharana Karana is called as Karana. तथाच करणार्थे तृतीय इत्युक्त्या अर्थ प्रदानादिकं प्रति श्री गौर्यादिः करणम् therefore what has been mentioned there as विघ्नहर और सर्वार्थ सकलार्थ प्रदा श्री गौरी they are karanas ईश्वरस्तु साधारण कारणम् इति ज्ञापितम् so what has been shown is ईश्वर इज साधारण कारण whereas there are some असाधारण कारणास Now, there is a Purva Paksha. Nacha itara pekshayam satyam ishwarasya svatantre hani syaditi vachyam. So, there is an objection to this. If you say Ishvara depends on Shri Gauri, Shiva depends on Shri Gauri and Ganesha to give anything to the devotee of Shiva, then Shiva is dependent. So, Nacha वाच्यम So the Purva Pakshi is being answered as to you shouldn't say this. You should not raise this objection as to what? Itara apekshayam satyam, when there is a dependency on someone else. Shiva expects someone to be there to do some good unto the devotees, then Ishwarasya Swatantre Hanihi. Then his independence is gone. The Karta is independent, Vyakrana so Swatantra Karta, and Ishwara has become dependent on his Karanas. You shouldn't say so. Why? Because this applies in Lokika also. He says, Pakade Kashtadyapeksha Satvyapi Devadattasya Tatkartrutvena Karaka Apreryatva Rupa Swatantra Darshanad. So he gives an example. Let's say Devadatta is cooking. Can he cook without all the karanas? Let's say he has vegetables, but he to cook the vegetable, he needs pakadehe kashtadyapeksha sattve. Api, even if he has a dependence on fuel, some kind of fuel, the old age fuel is wood. Or in an ashram kind of setup, temples, orthodox ones, they still use wood. So kashta, wood, is expected. So he has a dependency. Without wood, he cannot cook. Without fuel, he cannot cook. But that does not take away his kartrutva. He is still swatantra. Swatantra karta. He can cook. He may not cook. Kartum, akartum, anyathava kartum, shakyate. He can cook in a different way. So there may be a dependency on karana, but does not take away the swatantra of the karta. Tat kartrutvena karaka apreryatva. He is not influenced by the karaka. That kind of karaka apreryatva rupa swatantra darshanad. We have seen that such independence is there for the karta of the cook in this example. Ataha sveshta devatayahana swatantra hanirti bhavaha. Therefore, Ishta Devata Shiva, Kashika Shiva, Kashikesha Shiva has no dependency on others in his Swatantarya. He is still independent. You cannot say that he is dependent, he is independent. Sveshta Devatayana Swatantarya Hanirti Bhava Dundi Vigneshwara Ityartha Idam Padam Rudam Iti Jneyam. We have seen this yesterday. Rudi Artha of Sri Dundi is, Dundi means Vigneshwara, Sri Ganesha. Upakarnaihi Sadhanai Ityartha, and these Upakarnas, Charma Kapalas is Upakaranas, they are his sadhanas, they are his means to cover the body or whatever. Pancha Viduram means Nasha Rahitam, Shad Bhava Vikara Rahitam Iti Bhavaha. So by saying Anta Viduram, meaning bereft of Nasha, bereft of any end, Ananta, he is already Anadi, Ishwara is Anadi and now Ananta also. So one who is Aja, unborn, has no end, he will not go through any of the vikaras, shadbhava vikaras, asti jayate, vardhate, all these viparinamate, all these vikaras, in the end there is nasha. By saying nasha rahitam, all the other five vikaras are also denied to Ishwara. He is changeless entity. Mukaiti. So mukobi pandita bhavati in the third verse. Mukopi Pandita Shastrartha Jnana Purvaka Vakpraudhima Shali Bhavati Ityartha. So what is this Panditiyam? Not all sorts of Pandityams are to be sought after. So what kind of Panditya does a person gets by praising or worshipping? Vani Devi Saraswati is said here as this Muka Dumb also becomes Pandita. What kind of Pandita? He becomes Vakpraudhima Shali. He becomes a good orator. He can teach others also. How? Not by just, you know, having some skill set. Not just an oratory. There are many people who are good at giving bhashana. But this is not just that bhashana. It is Shastra Jnana Purvaka. So he gets the Shastra Jnana by the Anugraha. So what he talks is Yathartha Jnana. He has Yathartha Jnana and conveys Yathartha Jnana. He becomes an apta. You can trust that person, that kind of a pandita. He becomes, that kind of panditiyam should be sought after. This is the third verse. Then in the next verse, the introduction is Guru Parama Guru Parameshti Guru Stauti. In the next verse that we just read, Kamakshi Ityadi, देर गुरु दी ऑथर्स गुरु हिज परम गुरु एंड परमेष्टि गुरु दे आर ऑल प्रेज एंड सुस्तौति सो दि रामानंद यति भगवान रामानंद यति प्रेजेस हिज गुरु परम गुरु एंड हिज परमेष्टि गुरु सो गुरुज गुरु एंड गुरुज गुरुज गुरु सो लीनिएज ऑफ थ्री सो व्हाट वाज द वर्स कामाक्षी दत्त दुग्ध प्रचुर सुरनुत प्राज्य भोज्याधि पूज्य सो प्राज्य भोज्य अधिपूज्य श्री गौरी नायक अभित प्रकटन शिव रामार्य लब्ध आत्म बोधैहि दिस इज अ सिंगल वर्ड इट्स अ सिंगल कंपाउंड एंड इन तृतीया एंड दिस इज बहुरी सो लब्ध यू सी दिस लब्ध निष्ठा प्रत्यय तवतु निष्ठा निष्ठा पूर्वं बहुरीहौ इन अ बहुरी निष्ठा goes in the पूर्वपद सो लब्ध आत्मबोधः लब्धः आत्मबोधः यैहि और वी कैन स्प्लिट इट एंड से लब्ध आत्मबोधः येन एंड देन डिक्लाइन इट एज यैहि बिकॉज दिस इज इन थर्ड केस प्लूरल लेटर सो दोज बाय हुम आत्मबोध हैज बीन अटेन्ड एंड हु आर दीज दोज इन द सेंस प्लूरल इज फॉर culturally in Indian languages which have an influence of Sanskrita also the respect is given in plural so even if it is one guru he is addressed in plural so who is that who got this atmabodha and how so what kind of guru so here you look at it this Srimad Gopala Girbhihi This is in Tritiya Bahuvachana, just like this Labdhatma Bodhihi Antapada. So, Srimad Gopala Gihi. So, that Swamiji is his guru. And so, one of the three gurus, who will see? He attained Atma Bodha from whom? From one who is Kamakshi Datta Dugdha Prachura Suranuta Prajya Bhojyadhi Pujya. Shri Gauri Nayaka Abhit Prakatana Shivaramarya Labdhatma. So Shri Shivarama Arya. That is the Parameshti Guru whose Krupa. And what kind of Parameshti Guru is he? By whose Krupa? Srimad Gopala Ghihi got Atma Bodha. And what kind of Mahanubhava was the Guru's Guru? He was such an entity, such a personality that the Kamakshi Devi. So, near Kanchi, this Kamakshi Devi is Prasiddha. So Kamakshi Datta Dugdha, the payasa which is made from milk, that which has been given by the Devi herself, Kamakshi Devi herself. I'm not going to each words because we'll see something in the Tika also. So that is a Nevidya for Shri Gauri Nayaka Bhit Prakatana Shivaramarya. So this Shivaramarya Swamiji was such an entity that is befitting to offer to him. And through his grace and teaching, Srimad Gopala Ghihi attained Atma Bodha. And this Prakatita Paramadvaita Bhasa, once he attained that, then this Advaita Bhana which took place in his mind, which is Prakata now, Paramadvaita, not other kinds of advaitas which you know is a temporary you know the shuddha advaita dvaita advaita not any of those parama advaita this parama advaita kevala advaita tattva which is the brahma tattva that brahma jnana was clear to him and through that what happened due to that so you can say hetau tritiya also due to that this tritiya anta pada ड्यू टू दैट स्मितास्य यू कुड सी दैट ब्लिस ऑन हिज फेस ही वाज इन द आनंद स्वरूप सो अस्य मुख सो ही हैड अ स्माइलिंग फेस एंड दैट स्माइल वाज नॉट यू नो द प्लास्टिक स्माइल ऑफ दीज अदर्स दैट यू सी इट इज that smile which comes which manifests out of atmananda not vishayananda again continues this is not the end of the samasa so smitasya shrimad govinda vani charana kamalagah and this is the guru shrimad govinda vani charana kamalagah and this is the one who guru who had the smiling face due to the आत्मानंद ड्यू टू वॉट प्रकटित परमाद्वैत भाषा एंड दिस इज इन तृतीय बाय हिम आल्सो द परम गुरु आल्सो द गुरु वाज टॉट एंड द गुरु अटेंड दिस आनंद स्वरूप एंड हु एम आई द ऑथर ऑफ भाष्य रत्न प्रभा सो दैट भगवान रामानंद यति सेज आई एम यथा अली ही अहम यथा अली ही निर्वृतः तथा हम निर्वृतः अस्मि आई एम फ्री और एकम्प्लिश्ड निर्वृतः इज एकम्प्लिश्ड बाय व्हाट बाय अटेनिंग द हाईएस्ट इज व्हाट मोक्ष परम पुरुषार्थ Only purusharthas really, but parama purusharta. If you consider there are four purusharthas, and he says yatha alihi. Alihi is the is a bee. Just like a bee finds itself accomplished, satisfied, and considers that my task is over when it tastes honey, the juice of the flower. So here kamala gaha. So I am comparable to that bee who attains the flower. Similarly, I have attained this lotus feet, the flower, which is the lotus flower, and this lotus is a comparison given to the feet of the guru. So he says, "Shrimad Govinda Vani Charana," and the Charana is a praise. Generally, even the Vani is praised through the Charana, saying that his teaching made me free, and his teaching. I get the teaching just by falling at his feet. So this is a stuti. It is an arthavada. It is not literal, obviously. There is grace, of course. Anugraha is there, but then vani charana is a praise. So there in sampradaya, even the pitadisha is called as you know shri charana. So shri charana means what? Shri charaneyasya. Shri itself is Lakshmi. Comes from his feet, so that is a praise. It's a stuti because Parabrahma Tattva. You compare the Guru to the Parabrahma Tattva, where manifestation is in all forms, be it Lakshmi or Saraswati or any which way. So anyway, with this, let's look at the Tika a bit and move on. So Kamakshi iti Advaita Bhasa iti. What is Advaita Bhasa? Advaita Brahma Vishayaka Shastra Janya Prama iti Arthaha. So this bhasa, the shine of Advaita is not the you know luster, literal luster. Prakasha is not prakasha, it is Chaitanya Swarupa Jnana. And in the Chaitanya also will manifest in the Antakarana as the Jnana Vritti. So that is explained as Advaita Brahma Vishayaka Shastra Janya Prama. It's a Yatharta Jnana. Prama is Yatharta Jnanam. In keeping with the Vastu, that Vastu is Brahma, which happens to be me, Atma. So the understanding is Aikya Jnana. And this Aikya Jnana you cannot stumble upon. It is not something that, you know, comes from any other means. Only a singular means. Pramana is Shastra. Therefore, it is Shastra Janya Prama. And what is the subject matter of the Shastra? It is Advaita Brahma Vishayaka. Not any other Brahma Vishayaka. It is not, you know, Purana Vishayaka. Somebody talked about, praised, and then others being looked down upon. And it is not an Upasya Devata also. It is that Brahma Tattva which manifests as Aham in each and every individual. And once that manifestation and individuality is negated, then you know through the neti neti prakriya that I am that Brahma. There cannot be any other possibility. That is the conviction. That is Advaita Brahma Vishayaka Shastra Janya Prama. That is Advaita Bhasa. Advaita Bhaha and then Bhasa. Tritiya. Shri Guru Smitasyattva Nama Jivan Mukti Jyotaka Mukha Vikasa Vattvam. And what is this Smitasyattvam? This Guru had Smitasya. Guru is Smitasya, you can say, Bauri, who had a smiling face. What kind of smile is this? This is a smile which is what? Jivan Mukti Jyotaka. It reveals his Jivan Mukti Ananda. It is an inference, of course. It's an anumana. It may or may not be true, but then there are, you know, these other ways whereby you can know. You can, you know, this Shastra Pravritti. So there are lakshanas which are there, but you cannot guarantee. An ajnani cannot know a jnani, but then still, the behavior of the jnani is, the behavior of the guru is like the jnani. You can see the ananda. He is independent on anything for his ananda. So that is mentioned as Jivan Mukti Jyotaka Mukha Vikasa Vattvam. So his smile is due to that Nitya Ananda that he is having Anubhava of. Again, it is manifest. He is Brahma Swarupa, Brahma Veda, Brahma Yubhavati. But in Antakarana, if no other Ragadvesha, Kamadi, Doshas are there, if they aren't there, then what will happen? The same Brahma will shine. Just like a clean mirror, if there is no dust or dirt on the mirror, what will shine is the original Bimba, and it will shine completely as much as it can shine in the mirror. Antakarana will obviously limited. So you cannot have Ananta, Ananda experience. That is why, you know, the books translate as bliss. Bliss is generally a term used when you say that it is not experiential Ananda. When you say happiness, one can say, oh, it is this happiness, that happiness. But bliss cannot be qualified. There is no Visheshana possible to bliss. So this is the understanding when bliss is translated. We have to understand that it is not experiential Ananda of the Swarupa, because the experiencer is the one who is in that Swarupa. So Ananda is the experiencer. And as soon as one manifests as an experiencer and tries to experience oneself, it is not possible. Kartru Karma Virodha is there. Therefore, the manifested Ananda in the Antakkarana is due to nothing else being there. The Guru is not taken away by anything else. Even in the midst of everything else that is going on, he is free, independent of trying to draw Ananda from the circumstantial or surrounding Vishayas. Therefore, what will manifest is Ananda. And that is why it is said in Jivan Mukti Viveka, Bhagavan Vidyaranacharya says that even after Jnana, Jnana may make you free. You may get Videha Mukti in the end. But Jivan Mukti Ananda to manifest, there may be yogika process needed where you need to withdraw. If the sadhana chatushtaya sampatti is not complete, then nididhyasana will be a longer journey for Ananda. If you are okay with not having Ananda manifest, that is fine. You can still be free by jnana. Shravana is finally going to lead you to moksha, that mukti. But if you have in your prarabdha, or you want to fight that prarabdha, which is dukkha rupa, maybe for a jnani also there can be dukkha because sharira is there. And if the jnani wants to be free, just like he treats the body with, you know, the jnani's body is treated, the jnani also says, okay, you treat this body with doctors and all sorts of medications, yogika process is another treatment. So we should take it in that manner that one can withdraw from the sharira influence also by ananda, tapping Ananda, and there is nothing wrong with it. In Vichara Sagara, those who have attended, they have seen that in Vichara Sagara, the Vishaya Ananda and the Swarupa Ananda are separated. Even in the Samadhi, if somebody is wanting a Jnani, not an Ajnani, Jnani wanting Samadhi Krita Ananda, Samadhi Janya Ananda is different from Vishaya Ananda. It is not Vishaya Ananda. There are many people who compare it with the Vishaya Ananda. It is not, because he is already free. So there is a huge difference. We should remember this. Anyway, so that's an aside. What is mentioned here is जीवन मुक्ति द्योतक मुख विकास निर्वृत मोक्ष सुखम प्राप्त अस्मि. So what is nirvrata? How am I accomplished? He says, I have attained moksha sukha. Just like the guru has moksha sukha, he has transferred that vritti through teaching unto my antakarana. So as soon as he taught me tattvamasi, I understood aham brahmasmi with of course manana and nididhyasana. Now I have that sukha manifest. So moksha sukham prapta is the meaning of nirvrata asmi. Yatha alihi, example is yatha ali kamalagaha. So the alihi is kamalaga, one who kamalam gachati iti kamalaga, one who always tries to go towards the kamala, that kind of me. I always want to go towards the guru's feet, just like the bee wants to go towards a flower. So kamalaga san makaranda panena nirvrata bhavati yatha tatha, just like a bee becomes accomplished or is satisfied, its goal is met by the makaranda pana, by drinking the honey or the juice of the flower, which is what collected becomes honey for us. But the raw form of that, the purest form, is tapped by the bee itself. Tatha, similarly, me too, Shri Guru Pada Padmanusandana san. So, taking to refuge unto this Guru, tat prasada sadita advaita jnanina aham brahmanandam anubhavami iti bhavaha. So, I am experiencing this ananda, I have this brahmananda anubhava, I have jnana of this sadvastu, which is me, which is ananda also. So sachidananda vastu is not elsewhere to be sought after, it is my swarupa. Therefore, by giving up every other search, by dropping that search, because this seeker is the sought, who cannot be ever objectified. So by dropping that search, I remain what I am, and that is my ananda swarupa. So in the antakkarana, as long as body is there, antakkarana is there, so long there will be reflection of my swarupa ananda there, and that is the anubhava, that is the expression of anubhava of the swarupa ananda. Gantha drashtrunam, there is a type where this should be dirgha. Grantha drashtrunam anayasena artha bodhaya Swakruta shlokanam swayameva vyakhyam arabhate. I think this is not there in the other books. Some books it is missing. But then there is Ratna Prabhakara himself gives a note on his verse of Kamakshi Adi. Why? So that those who see this grantha, for them anayasena bodha takes place. Without effortlessly they understand the complicated verse, because it's a long samasa. We don't know who's who, and we don't know what, how the words fit in. Complicated words. He also found that, and then he says that Swakrita shlokanam swayameva vyakhyam arabhate. He begins a vyakhya on his own shloka by saying what? Moksha puryamiti. So I've color coded it so it is easy to go back. Moksha puryam. Moksha puryam is what? Shri Kanchyam. In Shri Kanchi. Mokshapuri is Shri, this Kamakshi Mokshapuriyam Shri Kanchyam. Where there is this Shri Kamakshi Devi, so Shri Kamakshya Dattam. Strityade, Kamakshi Dattam is Kamakshya Dattam Payasam. The Dugdha is Payasam Deve Rapi Stutam, which is Abhit, which is Prachura Suranuta. Suranuta, praised by Suras. Suras are Devatas. So praised by devatas, devairapi stutam yat payasam, kidrasham payasam, yat payasam shri kamaksha dattam tadrasha payasam, devairapi yat stutam prajyam, and prajyam sampurnam. Not as you know, you take the prasada from devi and then somebody comes, you offer a little. Not that way. Says that the entire thing can be offered to this guru. He is Parameshti guru. He is that kind of a guru. That which is not even accessible, rarely accessible to devatas, that kind of payasa can be offered to him, is yogya. In fact, not can, it is yogya to be offered to the guru. Devairapi sutam prajya means what? Sampurnam. Prakrushtajya yuktam va. Sampurnam or Prajya can be interpreted another way as what? Which has lot of Ajya, meaning lot of ghee. वा यद भोज्य मन्नम एंड इट कैन बी दैट पायसम विच इज मेड विद दैट काइंड ऑफ अ इनग्रीडियंट दोज इनग्रीडियंट्स एंड देयरफॉर भोज्यम अन्नम भोज्य अन्नम विच कैन बी विच इज कंज्यूमेबल विच कैन बी ईटन एडिबल तेन आधिपूज्यः एंड दिस इज समथिंग थ्रू विच ही शुड बी ही इज वर्शिप वर्दी थ्रू दीज मीन्स श्री शिवराम योगिनः एंड हु इज दैट श्री शिवराम योगिनः मीन्स श्री शिवराम योगी इन प्लूरल एज रिस्पेक्ट किंच शिवश्च असौ हिज नेम इज शिवराम सो किंच शिवश्च असौ रामश्च इति स्वनाम्ना श्री गौरी नायकयोर अभेदं प्रकटयन्ति व्हाट इज सेड हियर एज श्रीमद बिफोर दैट श्री गौरी नायक श्री गौरी नायक इज शिव एंड अभित दिस श्री शिवराम आर्य हु इज इष्ट परमेष्टि गुरु दैट परमेष्टि गुरु हैज द नेम शिवराम एंड बाय हिज नेम व्हाट इज ही शोइंग दैट ही इज Rama also, Shiva also, or showing that there is no difference between Shiva and Rama. That is mentioned as Shiva is Shri Gauri Nayaka. Avit Prakatana Shiva Rama Arya. So that is mentioned here by his own words. Shivascha Asau Ramascha Karmadharaya. Shiva is Rama, Rama is Shiva, Swanamna Shri Gauri Nayaka Yor Abhedam. Prakatayanti. So this can be taken as Shri Gauri Nayaka as what? Shri Nayaka and Gauri Nayaka. Shri Nayaka is Lakshmi Nayaka Narayana who took the avatar of Rama and Gauri Nayaka is who? Gauri Nayaka is Shiva. So thereby, otherwise you don't see Rama here anywhere. So Shri Nayakascha, Gauri Nayakascha, Shri Gauri Nayakau. And Abheda between them. Tayoho अभित सो तयोः अभेदा अभित इज अभेदा हियर एंड अभेदा इज मेड टू बिकम प्रकट सो अभेदा इज प्रकट प्रकटन हु इज डूइंग दिस प्रकटन बाय हिज ओन नेम श्री श्री शिवराम परमेष्टि गुरु सो लिटिल कॉम्प्लिकेटेड कंसेप्ट बिकॉज अ लॉन्ग समासा इट्स डिफिकल्ट टू ब्रेक एवरीथिंग देयरफॉर ही हिमसेल्फ रोट दिस एक्सप्लेनेशन देयर सो श्री गौरी नायक श्रीनायकस्य श्रीनायकस्य गौरी नायकस्य तयोः मध्ये अभेदः अभेदं प्रकटयन्ति तेभ्यो गुरुभ्यो लब्धः आत्मबोधः एंड थ्रू दैट काइंड ऑफ अ गुरु हु शोज अभेद इन राम एंड शिवा और इन नारायण एंड शिवा वन हु हैज अटेन्ड दैट Who is that? Srimad Gopala Saraswati. Swamiji is Guru. Guru's Guru, Paramaguru. And then his Guru is Srimad Govinda Vani. Srimad Govinda Acharya. Actually, some books will show this work, Ratnaprabha, as written by Shri Govinda Acharya, Shri Govindananda Saraswati. But here it is, you can see in the Mangala Charana itself, he does Mangalacharan Namaskara to Shri Govindananda also. Therefore, the work is by Shri Ramananda Yati. Or it can be that a part was written by his guru as well. Or it can be, you know, the way Plato says, Plato says that everything that I say is all Socrates. So, it is claimed as by Plato, but it is by Socrates. Of course, a Western example, but this may be more famous, you know, these days. Or the way you see Panchadashi. Classical example is Panchadashi, written by Vidyaranyacharya as well as his guru. Some parts may be written, or he attributes this to guru, that I say nothing that the Sampradha has not said. So everything should be like that. So there is no originality in creating something new. It is all what is Sampradaya Prapta, beginning from Ishwara himself. Okay, Tair Ityartha. Then the Tikakara further says, प्रकृष्टं प्रचुरं प्राज्यं अदभ्रं बहुलं बहु इति कोशमाश्रित्य व्याख्याति संपूर्णमिति सो देयर इज अ वर्ड देयर इन प्राज्य इन द कोश सो ऑल दीज आर पुट टुगेदर इन द डिक्शनरी ऑल दीज आर पुट टुगेदर सो प्राज्य मीन्स कंप्लीट संपूर्ण बेस्ड ऑन दैट ही हैज एक्सप्लेन्ड प्राज्य मीन्स संपूर्ण एंड देन अभित पदस्य अभेदार्थकत्वं कथयन् शिवराम इति स्वनाम्ना एव शिवरामयोर वेदांत इतिहास पुराण प्रतिपाद्यम अभेदम शिवर श्री शिवरामयोगिनः ज्ञापयन्ति इत्यतः देवता कटाक्ष लब्ध अद्वैत निष्ठापराश्च परमेष्टि गुरवः इत्येतम् अर्थं स्फुटीकरोति इति. सो व्हाट इज द आइडिया देयर किंच शिवश्च असौ इति व्हाट हैज बीन एक्सप्लेन्ड देयर द आइडिया अभित मींस अभेद बिटवीन हुम शिवा एंड विष्णु और नारायण. सो शिवरामयोर और शिव एंड नारायण हाउएवर यू टेक इट. सो देयर इज दिस अभेद which is the meaning of abhit shabda which is seen not only in vedanta. If you study itihasa purana also well, then you will see this abheda pervading through and through. Shruti, smriti, purana, itihasa, all the shastras have abheda as their tatparya. Between whom? Not only between brahma and jiva, which is the tatparya vishaya of course, but then if you see Puranas also, where one deity is praised against others, if you study them, you know that it is the manifestation of Ishvara in one form or the other which is praised. So, Abheda is known through them as well, between Rama and Shiva as well. And Devata Kataksha Labdha Advaita Nishta Parascha Parameshti Guru. So, this Parameshti Guru is one who has got the grace of Devata Ishvara Anugraha, due to which he had Advaita Vasana and gained this Abheda Jnana, which he gave to the Paramaguru, and then through that Paramaguru to Guru and through that Guru to me, says Bhagavan Ramananda Yati. Swanamna Ichchanena Advaita Sadhaka Yukchanveshanaya Tesham Chitta Vyagrata Nastiti Jyotyate. And what is shown is that the simplicity of the person, he has no compulsion to prove this Advaita to anyone. Na Buddhi Vedam Janayat, says Bhagavan Gitacharya Krishna. So here, he shows the Advaita just by his name. His name itself is Shivarama, therefore he does not have to take an effort. There is no Chitta Vyagrata, there is no compulsion there, there is no unease to establish his Advaita. It is easily established by him. Gurubhya Parameshti Gurubhya Ityartha. So it's the grand, grand Guru, Srimad Gopala Saraswati Bhiriti Parama Guru Bhiriti, who is Grand Guru, Guru's Guru, Tirtha iti Shastra ityartha. So there is a word Tirtha there. So this is in the next verse, sorry. It's in the next verse. So that is the fourth verse. The fifth verse of Mangalacharana is what? Shri Shankara Bhashya Kritam. This was, Shri Shankaram Bhashya Kritam Pranamya Vyasam Harim Sutra Kritam Chavachmi Shri Bhashya Tirtham. Parahamsatushtyai Vagjalabandachidam Abhyupayam. This print is not clear. This is Bhashya Tirthe perhaps, yeah. Sorry, so Shri Shankaram Bhashya Kritam Pranamya Vyasam Harim Sutra Kritam Chavachmi Shri Bhashya Tirthe Parahamsatushtyai Vagjalabandachidam Abhyupayam. So Vagjalabandachidam Abhyupayam Vachmi. I am going to give an upaya. I will state an upaya, a means for what? Vagjala bandha chheda. Chheda. Paricheda. I am going to give you a means, says the author, that I will give you a means to reveal the words which are hidden in this Vagjala. So the bandha, they are all Baddha in the Vagjala, the net of words, which may not be easy for everyone. So he says, I'll make it easy by giving you a means. To whom? And for what purpose? And doing what? King Kritva. Shri Shankaram Bhashya Kritam Pranamya. Vyasam Harim Sutra Kritam Cha Pranamya. Aham Vagjala Bandha Chidam Upayam Abhyupayam Vachmi. I will give you Abhyupayam. I will give you a complete elaboration and means to understand the Bhashya and the Sutra, which is Vagjala, and there is everything that I say hidden there. So Tikakara is not saying anything new. Vyakhyanakara is not saying anything new. Everywhere in the Sampradaya, whatever comes in the Tika is from the Bhashya. Whatever comes in the Bhashya is from the Sutra. Whatever is in the Sutra is Ishvara Prapta. he has come from the sampradaya, so we should have that shraddha in the shastra. Shri Shankaram pranamya, having bowed down to Bhagavat Padacharya, Bhagavan Bhashyakara, who is Bhashyakrita. So here is Kartarikta, and Vyasa, who is Hari. Vyasacharya, Bhagavan Vyasa, is no one but Hari himself, who has taken an avatara to protect the Vedas and keep the dharma going. And so that others understand what is this tatparya of the shastras. And Shri Bhashya Tirthe, this Tirtha is mentioned in the Tika there. So Shri Bhashya Tirthe, in this Tirtha, whatever is hidden, Baddha, in the form of Vagjala, because it is Prasanna Gambhira, Bhashya, I will give you a means to understand that completely too. For what purpose? Paramahamsa Tushtyai. Generally, every Prasthanatraya is, we know by the name Prasthana itself, that one should take up the study when one is willing to leave the samsara, one is not wanting to be trapped. So one should be able to give up everything for the sake of moksha. So these are Paramahamsas. So for their Tushti, Santushti, I give an Upaya. So Tika there, fourth distinct Tika said there as what? Tirtha iti Shastra ityartha. Tirtha is Shastra. Hamsa padasya pakshiparatvetu jala ityartha. So Tirtha can mean what? Here he says Tirtha is Shastra. What is that Tirtha in the Shri Bhashya Tirtha? What has been said? Shri Bhashya Tirthe. Shri Bhashya, which is Shastra. Not Shri Bhashya. Shri Bhashya is a title given to Ramanujacharya's Bhashya. So this is Bhashya, where, Shri Yukta Bhashya. That Bhashya itself has Shri. You don't have to look for any other Shri. So Shri Bhashya Tirtha Shastra, Tasmin Shastre Ityartha. Or, so Tasmin Shastre, whatever is hidden, Vagjala Baddha. Or what? If you say Paramahamsa is not a sannyasi, if it is a comparative, if it is just a comparative saying that for the birds, then what will it mean? Then Paramahamsa Tushte. Pakshi Paratve, what has been said is Pakshi Paratve. Hamsa Padasya Pakshi Paratve tu Jala Ityartha. So then you have to say that this Tirtha is a Jala, where there is something hidden. And unto that, there is this exposition written by Bhagavan Ramanandayati. Further, Vistruta Grantha Vikshayam Alasanyasya Manasam Vyakhya Tadaptham Arabdha Bhashya Ratna Prabhavida. So this Bhashya is Ratna. Bhashyam Eva Ratnam Tasya Prabha. And Abhida is in compound with that. So Bhashyaratna Prabha Abhida Nama Yasyaha Savyakhya. Yasya Vyakhya Savyakhya Arabdha. So this Vyakhya is begun by me, called as Bhashyaratna Prabha. Why? Tadartham Arabdha. For that purpose. Which purpose? The purpose is in the first line. Vistruta Grantha Vikshayam Alasam Yasya Manasam. Yasya Manasam Manaeva Manasam. So Manaheva Manasam. Manasam Alasam. The mind is lazy. Likes to be entertained. And if you see, look at this Prasthanatraya, what all is available also. The mind says, no, I don't want to get into all this. And that's how we end up saying, I can't get into all these details. And I'm okay with what I am, I'm happy. Because the mind has alasa. His mind is lazy to, is scared looking at this kind of a study, which is a Herculean task. Therefore, for such people who find so much of study and complex study difficult, and thereby their mind is withdrawn from all that, for Vistruta Grantha, and Vistruta is an expanse of Grantha. Vikshayam, having seen those, Vikshayam Alasam, in that sight itself, the mind becomes lazy. That's the idea there. Therefore, I begin this Vyakhya, says the आचार्य हियर एंड व्हाट इज व्याख्या व्याख्या इति पदच्छेद पदार्थोक्तिर विग्रह वाक्य योजना आक्षेपश्च समाधानम एतद् व्याख्यान लक्षणम व्हाट इज दिस व्याख्या और व्याख्यान व्हाई नॉट कॉल इट समथिंग एल्स टीका और एनीथिंग सो देयर आई मेंशनड दैट देयर इज अ टेक्निकल डिफरेंस बिटवीन टीका एंड व्याख्या सो व्याख्या ही कॉल्स इट एज अ व्याख्या बिकॉज पदच्छेद वेयर पदच्छेद इज गिवन पदार्थोक्ति व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ द पद पदार्थ इज स्टेटेड विग्रह इज गिवन सो डेरिवेशन इज गिवन हियर सो भाष्य इज रत्न भाष्यमेव रत्नम तस्य प्रभा सो दैट विल बी व्हाट दैट विल बी विग्रह वाक्य सो सम एक्सप्लेनेशन इज गिवन फॉर कंपाउंड्स आल्सो वाक्य योजना द अन्वय इज गिवन हाउ दीज वर्ड्स कम इनटू कनेक्शन विद ईच अदर आक्षेपश्च एंड इफ देयर इज एन ऑब्जेक्शन टू The Siddhanta that is given and Samadhana, answers to such doubts are also given. Etad Vyakhyana Lakshanam, this is the very definition of Vyakhyana. Iti Vyakhyana Lakshanam Veditavyam. What is Bhashya Ratna Prabha? Bhashya Ratna Prabha iti. Bhashya Meva Ratnam Tasya Prabha iti Artha. We saw this. Bhashya Artha Prakashakatva Dasya Granthasya Bhashya Ratna Prabha iti Namadheyam iti Bhava. What is the idea? Bhashya Artha Prakashakatva. Because it shows light upon the meaning of the Bhashya. Which is very convoluted otherwise has a lot of information hidden which Bhagavan Bhashyakara takes for granted. He does not think that gate crashers will be studying Bhashya. So to say we are all gate crashers, most of us are gate crashers because we don't have that kind of study that students had in his era. So this much we have to accept as a fact at the very least. So he assumes all this and then the other Tikakaras, Vyakhyanakaras saw this and they say that this will be very difficult. People will take it on face value. So they elaborated what Bhagavan Bhashyakara means. The study which is lacking earlier is filled in Tika and Vyakhyanas. Bhashyena, Sambhadi is the next, so sorry. So then Bhashyartha Prakashakatva, Granthasya Bhashyaratna Prabhaiti Namadhyaya. That is why it is called as Bhashyaratna Prabha. The last verse is what? Maybe the second last. Srimad. शारीरकं भाष्यं प्राप्य वाक्शुद्धिम् आप्नुयात् इति श्रमो मे सफलो गंगा मृत्योदकं यथा सो मे मम मे श्रमः सफलः माय एफर्ट हैज बीन सक्सेसफुल फलेन सह वर्तते इति सफलः इट हैज ऑलरेडी अटेन्ड और मेड अटेन आप्नुयात् सो हियर इट इज आप्नुयात् सफल सो शुद्धि मापनुयात वाक शुद्धि मापनुयात फर्स्ट इन द प्रेयर ही सेज दैट माय वाक इटसेल्फ मेड अटेन शुद्धि हाउ भाष्यम प्राप्य हैविंग अटेंड भाष्य मीन हैविंग हैविंग यू नो अंडरस्टूड दिस भाष्य और हैविंग जस्ट द एफर्ट मेड द एफर्ट ऑन एलाबोरेटिंग द भाष्य माय वाक विल अटेन शुद्धि दैट इज द श्रद्धा श्रीमत् शारीरकं भाष्य सो श्रीमत् शारीरक दिस शारीरक सूत्र इज शरीर संबंधी शरीर संबंधी इज आत्मा सो शरीरे भव इति शारीर इति वा सो शरीरे भव हु इज देयर इन द शरीर हु इज आइडेंटिफाइड टू बी इन द शरीर इज दिस जीवा जीवात्मा एज जीवा द आत्मा ब्रह्मात्मा हिमसेल्फ सो दैट ब्रह्मात्मा इज शारीरक सो दिस सूत्र By extension, Brahma Sutra is called Shariraka because actually Shariraka is Atma, Brahmatma. And Brahma, it is related to Brahma, therefore by Gauna Vritti, by extension, by Lakshana, Bhashya Sutra is also called as Shariraka Sutra. And the Bhashya on that is called as Shariraka Bhashya. So, Srimad Sharirakam Bhashyam Prapya Vak Shuddhim Apnuyat. Me Vak Shuddhim Apnuyat. Mama Vak Shuddhim Apnuyat. Iti Shramaha Me Safalaha. And thereby, if Vakshuddhi I get, then my Shrama will be Safala. He says it has already attained. Why? Because he is already creating this, and while creating itself, his Vakshuddhi is what is a minimum result that he would have got. So he is Safala, he is happy with that. And then, how is that? Gangam Rathyodakam Yatha. How? Shuddhim Apniyat Yatha Tatha. So, how Ganga. Having attained Ganga, the Rathyodaka. Rathyodaka is the water on the streets. The rain water gets accumulated on the streets on which Rathas, chariots, cars, all these are going in the modern world. That water is nothing. I mean, you don't want to play in that water. Children, when children play in the rain water, you know, muddy water, the parents say, oh, don't play there, you know. You want to protect your kids from diseases. That kind of water, obviously, you will not do achamana there or bathe there. But if it goes and meets Ganga, then Shuddhim Apniya, that water, same water which was otherwise filthy, now it has become Safala. That Udakam has become Safalam, having attained Ganga, because now that same water is Shuddha for not only bathing but for Achamana also. That kind of Safalatvam I have got by commenting on this Bhashya. Thereby Vak Shuddhi I have attained, and in the end the Tikakara says Bhashyam Prapyeti Bhashyena Sambadhya Iti Yavat. Having associated my Vak, associated with the Bhashya, just by mere association it has got Shuddhi. Vak Bhashya Yor Vyakhyana Vyakhyaya Bhavaha. What is the Sambandha between this, his Vak and his, which is, Vak is what? Vyakhyana. Now it is in written form that you call it as Vyakhyana, but it is all his Vak. So Vag Bhashyo, between the Bhashya and Vag, there is a Vyakhyana, Vyakhyaya Bhava. Vyakhyana is his Vag and Bhashya is Vyakhyaya, to be commented upon. So the commenting Vyakhyana or Vag and the Bhashya is the commented. So we'll stop here since we are doing the Tika as much as possible. We have covered the Mangala Charanas. I think the Mangala Charana is over. Oh, there is an 8th one. Let me look at it. If there is a long tika, I'll not do it. Otherwise, I'll finish it now itself. Up to you. Do you want to wait 5 minutes? I'll complete the Mangalacharana, or should we do it tomorrow? Okay, no response. Then we'll do it tomorrow. Okay.
Tomorrow.
Okay, we'll do it tomorrow. We are already ahead of time. Just thinking. यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदराप महत्पदं तमामाशु हरिं परमाशु जनकजाङ्गमनं सुखाकृतिं ॐ तत्सत् नमस्ते. एनी क्वेश्चन्स्? ऑलरेडी देयर इन द लिंक. Already they are uploaded and the link is shared on the description. Have a look there. Okay? Namaste.